Hello everyone and welcome to another game of World of Warships. Today we are watching Yukandaira in the Bismarck. He is on the map hotspot in a 3-point domination game mode, and it's a tier 9 battle. There are no carriers, but there are four destroyers in the enemy team, so we'll see how that turns out. And there are also three tier 9 battleships. Now, the Bismarck is, from what I've heard, a nice ship, pretty similar to the Tirpitz, but it does not have torpedoes. Instead, it has very nice secondaries, and from the description of this replay, Tucandeira is using a secondary build, meaning his equipment and captain abilities are focused on his secondary gun batteries. So, yeah. We will see a lot of shells raining down upon the enemies. Now, obviously, a secondary gun battery build is only working if you intend to get close to the enemies. And, well, German battleships tend to be good at brawling. So, let's see how this works out. Now, here we can see an Izumo. He is kindly enough showing broadside. And when we take a look at the battle overall, the enemy team has already moved into the point C. They have started capping. A friendly destroyer is already here going towards A. The enemies are taking B, but well, if the friendly team can secure A and C, it should be off to a good start. So now there is a Room who is also kindly enough showing broadside. And yeah, I think he already got punished for that by someone. Now he's turning away. But still pretty sizable hit here. Now, you wanna be careful here around A. It's very easy to just shoot torpedoes inside this point. And big ships will have trouble maneuvering here. Those islands might prevent you from escaping in the direction you want to. So, you already see here torpedoes incoming, so that's exactly what the enemies did. And also, here is the first kill. So, off to a good start. Unfortunately, the New Orleans here goes down, and yeah, this point is not where you generally want your battleship sailing into. If you push here too hard, you will just get obliterated by torpedoes and probably all those enemies. So you wanna have a destroyer inside here capping. And the friendly destroyer is still around here. He'll probably try to cap this now. And Tucandeira is providing fire support. Now he is turning around here. He wants to get out of this point and doesn't wanna push into the torpedo trap. We can also see his secondaries blazing away. And well, unfortunately, the York just got unspotted here, but still he managed to hit. Now he is in a not in an ideal spot here with the island in front of him, but he still has some torpedo cover from those islands, I guess, and he is reasonably well angled against those enemies. Now we can see here the torpedoes coming in. And the reason why you don't want to push inside this point too hard. Now, unfortunately, the friendly destroyer is lost, so there is nobody trying to cap this point anymore, which will make it quite a bit harder. There are also two battleships here. Not exactly sure why they are here. They don't seem to be very aggressive here on this side, and they aren't in a good position to support A. They should probably have moved somewhere around here. But it would seem like there are still quite a few enemies here left, so maybe some enemies will come around here and engage those two battleships. Now, on the other side, the friendly team has managed to capture the point C, and it looks like those ships might be going for B. If those destroyers now turn around and, well, help here at B, the friendly team could be able to make something happen here. Especially if those ships here might even reinforce that as well, but it's not looking likely so far. Now to Candeira here, he wanted to make something happen at A, but he doesn't really have any support. Those ships, maybe they will come back here and help out, but currently they are not really in a position to support A directly. They can engage probably some battleships down here. And I guess this cruiser is also going here on the outside. Now the enemy destroyer is trying to capture A, not really much you can do about it. And here on the other side of the map, I'm not really sure where those destroyers are going. There really isn't much happening here on this side of the map. They should focus on B, I would say. And I think with all of those enemies spotted, those battleships stopped advancing towards B as well. It's not looking good. Now Candeira can support his team here. They decided to push forward now and they have started engaging an enemy. So if they all have stick together, maybe they can kill those ships. That Izumo is unfortunately showing too much broadside. The tear pits here I think would be a great target. Maybe the York is... no, the York is too badly. Now Candeira doesn't wanna face straight this way, I guess, because he's under fire from this side and you don't wanna show your broadside towards a battleship. And yep, there goes that enemy. Now those islands should very soon provide cover against those ships. You could possibly push towards this tier pits, I believe. Of course, you gotta be careful if you push here too hard and there are still a lot of ships here. You might find yourself under too much fire. And we can see now the beautiful secondaries going off here. Now he slowed his ship down because he wants to use his secondaries to fire at this Izumo over this island. And well, it looks like the Izumo is returning fire and he's also here sitting broadside on, so there is a certain downside to this strategy. So now he is moving away, he is abandoning this position. It's too dangerous to show the broadside towards the Izumo too long, and there is the tear pits to deal with. Tear pits is also offering a broadside, which is very nice of him. And you always have to keep in mind that tear pits has torpedoes, so you don't want to be in a 6 km range of the tear pits. So now Candeira is turning his ship around. He is close enough for his secondaries to fire. There is no reason to get any closer and risk torpedoes. And well, that was a very nice bell hit here. Now since the tear pits is turning, I guess he's trying to fire torpedoes, but he's not in range, so it won't matter. There is an Iowa. There is an Iowa who has joined the party, which could get a little bit uncomfortable. That Iowa is still rather healthy, and yeah, he is a tier 9 battleship. Now the friendly destroyers have finally arrived at E by now, it seems, and they've almost kept this point, which is pretty nice. Most of the friendly ships seem to be a bit out of position, like I don't know what you want to do so, that far in the north or so close to that zone wall. And those battleships might be engaging those two ships, so... as to somehow, if those ships would converge here, like this point or something, they should be able to easily deal with those enemies. Now, Dukandeva himself, he is... well, he'd probably love to be closer towards A. But there is a problem, like the enemies are closing in from all sides and... well, his support is not really... well, this battleship just sunk, this battleship is running away, those ships are too far away, so he is basically alone here. What he can do is hopefully draw those enemies away from the fight. If a lot of enemies would follow him, he might be able to draw them away and maybe give those ships an opportunity to do something. Currently also they control at least two capture sites, so that's the good news. Now this Iowa is unfortunately not showing oh, maybe he is. That's a very nice hit, but yeah, he's also showing his broadside. Was pretty lucky there, I guess, that the Iowa didn't hit him harder. There is a zone wall approaching fast. Yep, that hurt. Yeah, by now it's looking pretty desperate. The friendly destroyers have been lost. Everything on this side of the map has basically been lost. The remaining ships are pretty much out of position. And there are quite a few enemies still remaining. On the bright side, the Iowa is almost down. So... let's hope he can deal with her soon. Yeah, and there is more fire incoming from over there. Now he's using his front guns, I think, on the Indianapolis because they probably can turn that far towards the Iowa anyway. And the secondaries... well, maybe it weren't the secondaries, but this Iowa is dealt with, so now the Indianapolis is the next target. The heal is almost ready. Well, German accuracy is not that great in this game. Oh, he is doing his best to avoid the enemy's shells. And... his damage control is also on cooldown, so if the Indianapolis were to set him on fire now, it would really hurt. Now he's also bringing his ship around here, and yep, that worked. Getting closer would obviously have been an advantage because of the amazing secondaries. And luckily he is not burning. Meanwhile, the friendly team has lost the point B. Those ships are going help defend B. And there is still a cruiser who is a bit out of position now. Dukandeva himself is not in a very good spot. He is a bit too far away, but he was kind of chased in his corner. And while he prevailed, he will take him a while to get there. But he will now go capture A. And I hope those battleships will try to defend C. I mean, I think there is a destroyer in there. But look, it's 4 versus 4, and the enemies have a point lead and they have a capture zone lead. You cannot lose this point, but it seems like those battleships would disagree. Now at least this one battleship is pushing towards B. Hopefully the second will back that push up, because yeah, I mean, if they don't capture something soon, they're doomed. There is only 4.5 minutes left as well. So if they don't reach like 1,000 points, then I mean, they, with this point lead, they will win in 4.5 minutes. Now this is good. This Izumo is probably going to die. And this will give them a little bit more breathing room. It will also, yes. Now unfortunately, I don't know what this battleship is doing. Maybe it's trying to hunt down a destroyer, but you can't really chase a destroyer in a battleship, they are too fast. What he should do is he should focus on C or back up B. If he would go towards C now, and yes, the second destroyer might still be somewhere around there, but it's that won't change anything. If you die at C, at least you tried. But if they don't take this point, then they lose anyway, probably. Now I think these shells will probably... they beat them out. Well, some of them. Now it looks like the enemy battleship here is going down, so the friendly Scharnhorst can finally start capturing B. Lucantara will hopefully soon start taking A. Nobody is still at C. This battleship is still, I don't know, sailing in circles here. It's gonna be close, but it's still doable. If the destroyer is still somewhere around here and they get the destroyer, then probably, because they can, if they capture the points and kill the destroyer, killing an enemy ship will reduce points from the enemy and give you some points. I think they still have a chance. Of course, I mean, there are only 2 minutes left and the lead is so big, so okay, maybe even killing an enemy destroyer won't be enough. Maybe they have to kill both of them. And unfortunately, still nobody is taking point C. And I get it, in a battleship you don't want to fight in those such a position against a destroyer, but it's like either you try or you lose anyway, so you have nothing to lose. And now we gonna speed things up here a little, because there is not really an action happening here on the screen. Yeah, and time is almost over, so unfortunately, this is a loss. Now let's take a look at the results. Lucandeira managed to get 1901 base experience in a loss. Only one enemy on the winning team made more experience than he did. And looking at this value, I think the enemy Benson played really well. But anyway, Tukandera, I think he played this rather well. He tried to make something happen at A, but there just wasn't enough support from the team. And then he kind of got forced backwards, retreated. But while he emerged victorious, it was just... he was too far away from the other points to still make something happen. And I think the friendly team could have won if they'd just taken C a lot sooner. Or probably even defended it and not lost it in the first place. I know it's scary to engage a destroyer in that situation, but... well, if you lose anyway, otherwise you've got nothing to lose, right? Now, Tukandera managed to get First Blood, Dreadnought, Kraken, and High caliber, he did 211,000 points of damage. Very nicely done. 348 secondary hits. Now, the secondaries themselves did not do that much damage. They did like about 40,000, but the fires did like 58,000, and those are from secondaries, I'd say. So, yeah. Bismarck, definitely a fun ship. I'm looking forward to getting her myself, but I guess it will take me some time to get there. I hope you enjoyed watching this battle, and I see you guys next time.